Tuesday, the 11th of November. Good morning, this is Today with Justin Webb and James Nocht. 19 minutes to nine.
It's a very important test case in the Court of Appeal today. The bus operator, First Group, is appealing against a lower court ruling that when a company offers disabled access, it must ensure that disabled people genuinely have priority. The case involves Doug Pawley, who uses a wheelchair and was unable to board a bus near Leeds in 2012 because a woman with a pushchair was occupying the space. She refused to move or to fold up the buggy. Mr. Pawley is here. And on the line is Sally Whittle, who's a single mother of a nine-year-old daughter. She writes a blog called Who's the Mummy? Morning to you both.
Morning. Good morning.
Mr. Pawley, first of all, you won the initial case.
That's right. Well, Unity Law did on my behalf, but yes.
And what did that then win you? What right did you think that won you?
It clarified the law to make it clear that the wheelchair space is ultimately for wheelchair users, and whilst non-disabled people can use it when not needed by a disabled person, that ultimately, if a disabled person needs it, then it must be vacated.
So if that is upheld by the Court of Appeal,
yes,
then when a disabled person arrives on a bus and asked to use that space, whoever is there, whatever issues they might have, whatever they might be carrying, they must move, and the bus conductor, driver, must tell them to move.
That's basically it, yes. Particularly if a wheelchair user gets on and it's a non-disabled person in there, yes, that's right.
Sally Whittle, what impact do you think that would have?
I think for mums particularly, and dads, of course, who are travelling with children in pushchairs, it can be incredibly difficult. Public transport is not a joyous experience at the best of times, but if you're travelling with a young baby in a pushchair, there's a lack of storage space on public transport, and often those spaces are designated for pushchair users or for wheelchairs. And I think there are all kinds of reasons why a parent may not want to collapse the pushchair to make space. And I think really the onus should be on the bus companies to provide better provision and to provide equality to all passengers, not just to wheelchair users.
There might be some cases, Doug Pawley, mightn't there, where a child is asleep or a mother simply can't manage to organise getting the buggy into a storable space, where it would be quite impractical, wouldn't it, to get them to move, and there would be they would actually have to leave the bus.
I do appreciate it. It's incredibly difficult for mothers and fathers with young kids. And, you know, this is portrayed sometimes as being disabled people against people with pushchairs. I don't think it is. I think it's entirely possible for both to be accommodated on the bus. But ultimately, these are wheelchair spaces. They were designated as such. They were designed as such in the Public Service Vehicle Accessibility Regulations, and they happened because disabled people protested chaining themselves to buses in the 1990s so that disabled people could use the bus, you know. And there's no other space on a bus that a wheelchair user can use. You know, if that space isn't available, that person can't travel.
I suppose that's the point, isn't it, Sally Whittle? You're talking about a basic ability to get around.
Of course.
And that is what potentially, if this ruling is lost today, if it goes against Mr. Pawley, that's what would be lost.
I think that there's it's about a quality of access, and I think certainly, as having travelled myself as a mum with a child in a pushchair, I've had to wait while four, five, six buses go past until there's a bus that I can actually get on with a pushchair. And the reality is that if you have a pushchair, there may be all kinds of reasons why it can't be collapsed. Some parent-facing pushchairs, for example, simply can't be collapsed. If you've got items underneath the pushchair, you can't collapse it. If you do collapse it, often the question is, where do you put it? Because there are no spaces in the luggage racks, the bus is full and it's busy. And I think what we're at risk of doing is prioritising one group and then excluding another group from public transport, when the issue really should be about a quality of access applying to everybody.
Doug Pawley?
Oh, I agree. But the thing is that Parliament, in its wisdom, has given people with a protected characteristic of disability priority under the Equality Act. They have to make reasonable adjustments. I agree that there should be extra provision made for anybody who needs to use a bus who's got difficulties, and I'm fully up for supporting people in making that happen. But ultimately, at the moment, the law as it stands has been put in place to ensure that wheelchair users can use the bus.
Right, it all goes to the Court of Appeal today. Doug Pawley and Sally Whittle as well. Thanks both.
Thank you.